Hey guys, want to welcome you to a cold winter morning here in Kentucky, here at my mom's house to get ready to take her to the airport so she can hang out in Florida a little bit, get away from this. But this morning we have one of my favorite psalms that we are going to begin to learn together. And so thanks for being with us, and I pray that this time is a blessing for you. Story today is actually a psalm, it doesn't need a lot of introduction. This is one of my favorite psalms, just very interesting to me, and so I'm going to read it to you, and then I'm just going to talk to you a little bit about some of the ways that that I go about trying to remember this story. Again, I always follow the same procedure. I read it out loud, I turn off my phone or close my Bible, repeat as much as I can remember, then read it out loud again. That is the process that I follow at home. It's the process I follow in preparation for doing a story at church or any place else. But there's also some other things I do along with that just to help tickle the memory some. But that is the foundational experience. However, that's a little boring to watch on video, right? So we're not going to do that. But here's the psalm. It's Psalm 1. Blessed is the man who does not walk in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful or of the scoffers. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in God's law he meditates day and night. That man shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that brings forth its fruit in its season, whose leaf also shall not wither, and whatever he does shall prosper. The ungodly are not so, but they're like the chaff which the wind drives away. Therefore, the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish. And that's all of Psalm 1. And so as I go through there, as I'm looking just to remember the story, blessed is a man who does not. Well, it's interesting to me in this story that he's blessed for the things he doesn't do. So that just helps me in knowing how to, blessed is a man who does not walk, stand, or sit. And so I would put those walking, and then you stop, and then you sit. So there's a progression there in that part of the story. As I'm remembering the story, walking, standing, and then sitting. But his delight, and there, delight in the law of the Lord. You know, I'm picturing the law. And with the understanding, the law he had is the Old Testament law, right? So we're talking about the Pentateuch. Do you get excited about the Pentateuch? You know, Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. Is that, woo-hoo, is that your favorite part when you're reading your Bible through every year? Like, wow, I can't wait to get to Leviticus. Yet it says here, the man that is blessed delights in the law of the Lord, and he meditates day and night. So how does one meditate day and night? Well, you know, for me, I'm thinking the best way I can meditate is if I know it in my head and translate it to my heart. That man should be like a tree. And that's the reason I wanted to do this story out here. I'm out here by this little creek, and some of these trees have been here for a long time, but it's planted by the rivers of water. So it's always getting. I picture one of these trees, and it brings forth its fruit in its season, and its leaf doesn't wither. So I just see, it brings forth its fruit in its season. I'm adding those actions and expressions as I'm learning the story. Whatever he does shall prosper. That's an interesting phrase. And so even as I'm learning the story, I'm going, man, that's something I want to dig into when I'm leading in discussion on this, because is this teaching the prosperity gospel? Because that's immediately where people are going to go. That's where they're going to jump. And so as I'm learning my story, I just want to kind of make these little notes in my head. But the ungodly aren't so. So I'm going to add that little, you know, I'm going to add the ungodly are not so. I probably won't wiggle my head. But they're like the chaff that the wind blows away. See that little action expression. So therefore, because of that, the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. The Lord, see those actions and expressions, the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish. And so as I go through this story to learn it, I'm just going to add those little things, and it's amazing how much those things will help you. I would love to see in the comments section if there are other actions and expressions that as you're learning this story that naturally would come to you or that you would think of, because as you guys share these things with me, not only does it help me, but it helps the other people that are kind of following us and watching us. And speaking of following and watching, would love to have you subscribe. We're about to break another marker. And so anybody that will go to YouTube Butch Vernon STS and sign up for us, just be a personal favor. But till the next time, keep on telling those Bible stories.